Okay, let's see if I remember how to do this. Let me go to attendee. New field. Formula. Total spent?
Yep.
Return type, currency probably makes sense.
Yep.
All right, so we want to add our formula, and I'm trying to figure out how I would do this. Like, you know, 50 times tickets sold,
right,
or 100 times tickets sold, but it depends on the ticket type.
Yeah, so before this, we've been dealing with pretty simple formulas where it's just addition or multiplication. But in this case, we're adding a little bit of conditional logic where we're trying to figure out if it's one value, do this, if it's another value, do this. Mm-hmm. So let's go to the advanced formula tab and then look at some of the functions that we have available to deal with that kind of stuff. On the right-hand side, we have all the different functions you have available. If you click on that little pick list, you can even change it to functions on specific things. In this case, it'll be a logical function we want because we're logically trying to figure out if one thing or if the other. So immediately it's like if statement makes sense, right? But if you didn't know what you needed, you could Google it or go to the forums. All that's totally a fine way to find it.
What does this part mean? The if logical test, value if true, value if false?
So that's a little sample of the syntax of how to use the if statement. And what the logical test means is you provide it some sort of function that will be true or false.
Like ticket type equals VIP.
Exactly.
Okay.
And so if ticket type is VIP, it'll
do this first thing.
Do the first thing, which is
like 100 times the
ticket
number sold.
Number sold. And then if it isn't VIP, then it'll do the second parameter.
Okay. So 50 times ticket sold.
Yes. So that would be the general mission.
So that's what I do.